Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's learn about how to incorporate halides or halogen atoms in the names of molecules. Okay, so halides, and there are four common halides. There's fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. And the prefixes that we will use to describe these groups are at the top of the slide. Fluoro, chloro, bromo, and iodo. So let's see how these work. Remember, we've seen this molecule many times. This is hexane. And we even said we can put alkyl groups like methyl on our hexane, and we would name this 3-methylhexane. So we're going to number this. There are 6 carbons in line angle notation, and we'll number the chain so that our methyl group, our substituent, is closest to one of the ends of the chain, in fact the starting position. So we'll start on this end so that we'll get 3-methylhexane, as opposed to numbering from the other end, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So we prefer to have a lower number if we can get it. Okay, so what does this have to do with halides? Well, what if we had a bromine there instead of a methyl? Well, we don't have a methyl as a substituent. We have a bromine as a substituent, as a bromo. So we just say 3-bromohexane. And if we were to add, let's say, we had a methyl and a bromine. Well, on the left-hand side of the molecule, that's if we number from this side, we hit our first branch earlier, carbon 2. So we'll number from the left going to the right. That's our longest continuous chain. It's still a hexane. And now we simply list our substituents in alphabetical order. So the bromine, bromo, comes first, and it's at the 3 position. 2-methylhexane. Now, very often in organic chemistry, you will encounter multiple instances of the same group. So here is an example of that. Again, sticking with hexane. Here we have 3 chlorines in one molecule. Now, we're not going to, if we number this, numbers aren't very clear, but it's 1 through 6. The chlorine, we're not going to say 2-chloro, 2-chloro, 4-chloro. What we'll say is 2-2-4-trichloro. So we can put in a prefix to say how many chlorines we have. It's a little bit redundant because you notice we have 3 numbers. If we have 3 numbers, then we better have 3 of that substituent. But the prefixes are tri for 3, di for 2, tetra for 4. You'll rarely go over 4, but there are other prefixes, but we don't need to learn all those. But we can have multiple substituents. On the lower left, we said the bromine comes before methyl. Bromo comes before methyl because alphabetically it comes first. When you alphabetize substituents and you use this numerical indicator, di or tri, you don't alphabetize based on that. You alphabetize based on C. So you might look at this molecule. Let's do the same structure. And now let's put our methyl group in here. And you say, which comes first? Do I list my 2-2-4-trichloro? Or do I list my 3-methyl? Well, the trichloro comes first because we alphabetize that as a C, and that comes before the M. Now, there's one other thing I want to mention. Numbering doesn't always come the way I mentioned it. So this is now an alkene. This is going to be some kind of butene. And as soon as you name a molecule as a butene, the alkene has high priority. So actually, you number the molecule, the chain, giving the alkene precedence, and the chlorine just gets whatever's left over. So you would call this 4-chloro-1-butene because it's the alkene. We number from the end that's closer to the alkene, not that's closer to the branching chloride. So that's just a quick glimpse of how you incorporate halogens. It gives us an experience in numbering and the idea of putting numerical indicators, di, tri, tetra, and even a splash of how we number the ends of our chains. Which end do we number from first? Those are some quick rules in nomenclature with a focus on halides.